Dr. Meyer, I'm really glad that you're here, and I want to start this program by asking you to explain how the fossil record poses a problem for Darwinian evolution. It actually poses two big problems.
Right. Well, we've been talking about a doubt that Darwin had about the adequacy of his own theory, its ability to explain all the evidence. And his doubt concerned a major event in the history of life known as the Cambrian explosion, in which the first major groups of complex animals arose very abruptly in the fossil record. And this posed two problems, two mysteries that were really unresolved by Darwinian theory. The first I like to call the mystery of the missing fossils, because these animals appear very abruptly in the Cambrian layers, but as you go back into the lower Pre-Cambrian strata, you don't find any evidence of the ancestral forms of those animals, the simpler forms that you would expect to find according to Darwin's theory, because Darwin expected that the first complex forms of life would have emerged very gradually as a result of the accumulation of numerous slight variations or changes generation to generation. You just don't see the accumulation of those changes in the lower strata.
So that was a problem.
That was a big problem. But there's an even more fundamental problem, and one that we've grown to appreciate in much more depth in the 20th century and 21st century, and that's essentially an engineering problem. How would the evolutionary process have built these complex forms of animal life, especially since they arose so abruptly in such a narrow window of geologic time? And that's in my book. I look at both of those two mysteries, but the second mystery is more fundamental, and it's grown very much more acute because of things that we've discovered in modern biology during the second half of the 20th century, since the 1950s. And in particular, things that we've discovered about the information-bearing properties of living organisms and the information-bearing properties of the amazing molecule known as DNA.
Yeah. When Crick and Watson came out with this discovery, what did they show us?
Well, Watson and Crick made the extraordinary discovery in 1953 that is, you know, world-renowned. It was this, they were able to elucidate the structure of the DNA molecule, and they showed that the DNA molecule had this famed double helical structure with four chemicals running along the inside of that helix. And as most of us learn in biology class at some point, the DNA is the molecule that contains hereditary information, and it has a helical structure. Along the outside, there is this winding ladder, double helix ladder, made of sugar and phosphate. On the inside of the molecule, there are these four chemicals called bases or nucleotide bases.